listened to Dr. J just a few moments ago. Once again, apologize for the background noise and all the plates and shuffling around and sounding like it was in the kitchen. You know, but the honest truth is I have to thank John for being here and going out of his way. He lost power at his ranch, and he was doing this exclusive event for us, and he had to run to a local diner to get internet connection and do the conference from there. And once again, you know, I hope you learn a lot from it. Apologize for the background noise, but listen, that's what happens when you lose power, I guess. But he was able to come and fulfill what he wanted to do by speaking and educating you all about the options. And we will have him back again, so always look forward to listen when he comes back. So anyway, let's get started. I want to pick up where he left off. I know we have a really busy schedule today. We have a few more speakers coming on. I'm going to pick up, and then after me, we're going to have Hubert. We have Dungan and Rob Booker coming up next. All right. So with that said, is my audio coming in okay? Can everyone hear me nice and loud and clear? All right. Excellent. All right, now, because there's a lot of people in the meeting, the chat, everyone won't be able to read everyone's chat, but I'll be able to read it and be able to pick up and answer any questions. All right, so let's just get right into it, ladies and gentlemen. Let me make sure that we're recording, and we'll move forward. Remember, all these events are being recorded, so if there's something specifically you guys want to see and hear a specific speaker, it will be on our YouTube channel on CyberTrade University YouTube. And also on our website, we will be emailing all of you the logon instructions to review these videos once they're over. So really quick, a little quick disclaimer, just let everybody know that what you're hearing today, this is the high risk of involved in trading and past results don't indicative of future returns. CyberTrade University and all their individual affiliates on this site and this webinar assume none of your responsibilities. So once again, this is all strictly educational. So hopefully you learn a lot from it, but also just remember that there is a high risk to doing this. A couple of questions that are coming across, and I'll just answer them really quick. We have one question: do you expect a market correction in November? Actually, you know, as a trader, I personally think that we're hitting a triple top. If we do break through this triple top, then we should be fine. If not, then we will have somewhat of a correction. All right. So anyway, quick little intro about CyberTrade University, and then I want to get into the education part of it. First of all, for some of you who don't know this, we've been educating clients since 1995. I actually am the founder of the company. And just to let you know a little bit about who I am and why we're all here and why you should be listening to all of us here at the Cyber Expo 2013, is that, remember, all the speakers, including myself, were just like you. We started out at the bottom, and if you notice, every single topic that you read about any of the presenters, they're all going to be telling you the same exact thing I'm going to tell you. They were all trained and mentored by other traders. Okay, this is not something you could read out of a book. This is not something that you could just watch a couple of webinars. You need a mentor. You need a coach. Even Tiger Woods, the best golfer in the world, as of today, still has a coach. You know, all the speakers here, we all listen to everyone here. We always learn. And you know what? Every speaker here is going to listen to other speakers because we all never stop learning. 90% of your time is devoted towards education. Only 10% or even less is devoted towards trading. It's like football. You ever, anyone here follow football? You trade, football's only 60 minutes, but you're training all week for the event, and that's what you have to look at it. Now, for some of you, also, if you know a little bit about CyberTrade University, I'm also a 12-time champion at the Traders Challenge, held at the Traded Money Shows, Traders Expos. I've been to Paris. I've been to China. And what you're about to learn and see, you're going to realize that trading is not that difficult. It's actually quite simple. And I'm going to go over some of the things and show you why I became a 12-time champion and why I beat every school, because the people that you're seeing, including myself, we're all traders. We worked on the floor. We were mentored by the best. And you're here learning from the best. And this is it. This is something you want to do. This is what you have to look at. So let's talk about what we're going to be learning. We're going to talk about a day journal on what we do over the course of the day. I'm going to talk about level three, total view, the KISS method, finding stocks to trade, and much, much more. So let's talk about failure. Why do people fail? Why is trading so negative? They're constantly talking about, you know, everybody, you know, don't trade your own money, give it to the professionals. You know, there is a certain good thing about that, and there's also a certain bad thing about that. All right. I know there's a lot of you here that may be unemployed. Maybe you're too overqualified, can't find another job. Maybe you want to trade your own IRA. Maybe Social Security is not cutting it. You want to make a couple extra $100. Well, that's why you're here. You're here because you're saying, you know what? I want to learn how to trade. You know what? Why can't I do it? Why do I need someone else? And you're right. You should do it on your own. You should try it out. Trading is the best job in the world. But why do people fail? Same reason why people fail, you know, in anything, if it's a diet, if it's starting a business. It's because who really mentored you? How did you really learn? Well, and let me tell you I'm going to talk about, not about just making money, I'm going to talk about how people lose money, because I don't want to see anyone here lose money. And let's talk about the 50% failure rate of trading. Half the people fail in trading by opening up the wrong brokerage account. How many of you here open up a brokerage account and say, okay, you know, what do I do? How do I go about doing this? And next thing you know, you're finding out you can't get the guy on the phone. The system is slow. It doesn't trade certain markets. There are two types of brokerage firms. There are online brokers and direct access brokers. Now, kind of explained by, you could see from the diagram here, online brokers, they're not bad companies. I like them. I have it with my IRA. But if you're – the reason why most of you are probably here is because you're looking to trade as a career. You're kind of here because you want to kind of do things on your own. Well, if that's the case, then chances are – you have the wrong brokerage account if you're dealing with an online broker, because online brokers are trading against you. Now think about that, against me. Why would somebody trade against me? Because the way they do this is that they're not even buying the stock at the market. They're actually taking the bet that you're going to lose, because 80 to 90% of the people fail. They take your order, they sell it for payment for order flow. They sell stock. Let me just get my little crayons out here. They'll go out there and check if they have stock in inventory. You know, they'll go to their trading desk, try to buy it on the bid, sell a few on the offer. I mean, this is how online brokers make money. Now, if you are trying to take matters in your own hands, this is what I teach my students, how to trade on a direct access execution system. And this is the simplest way of explaining it. Online brokers are like dealing with public transportation. Direct access brokers are like dealing with driving your own car. Now, we know the big difference. My God, I mean, it's like, I know public transportation is great, and you know there's a necessity for these people, but at the end of the day, we're not going to surrender our driver's license just because it's cheaper, you know. And if you're out there looking at why these things cheap, and oh, this guy gives it to me free, why would I pay extra? You know, why would I buy a platform? Why would I pay a little extra more money in tickets? Because at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, it's the same thing like everything else. You get what you pay for. you'd rather go out there and lose money, go right ahead. But if you're looking to take matters in your own hands, the first thing you need to do is make sure your brokerage firm is direct access. Well, exactly, Paul. Paul's question is, by the way, example is Schwab and Fidelity direct access. Well, it depends. You have to ask them because they have different layers of trading. Brokerage firms do not make money on direct access trades. They want you to go through their online broker system. Most of them will require you to trade X amount of shares to get that access because they have to make some money somewhere. I mean, you think about it. You really think they make money charging you $5, $10 a ticket? You think they can get those nice commercials on being, you know, on the Super Bowl due to that? No, they don't. So that's rule number one. Now, let's talk about direct access, total view. All right. Now, does anyone here know what total view is? Does anyone here know what level three? I mean, this is – you guys ever watch CNBC? When we're talking about John Jeremy, he was just on. Did you ever see when he's on the floor of the CBOE or you see all the traders on the New York Stock Exchange? Do you ever see those screens behind them? Do you know what they're looking at? Think about it. What are those screens? Orders. That's right. Those are the big block orders. They're not charts. They're not computer programs. They are orders, and that's what you have to look at. So I'm going to teach you how to read orders. Now, here is an example of a level of a total view. B stands for buyers, S stands for sellers. Now, this is what my mentor taught me. When I first got on the job, let me tell you, I should have never made my first trade, and I'm hoping that I can convince all of you to feel the same way, because what you're about to see is what drives the market up and down. Supply and demand is what controls the market. So when you look over here, ladies and gentlemen, what do you notice on the bid side? Well, you see a lot of hundreds, but the thing that stands out is this 14,800 share buyer. On the bid side. On the sell side, what do you notice? 50, 100, 200. And then you have this one person, or it could be several people, at 40 to 63. So, once again, how do stocks control the market? What makes support and resistance levels on the chart? Buyers and sellers, supply and demand. Okay? So not only half of the people fail in trading because they have the wrong brokerage account. Thank you very much, Robert, for sharing that. You know, he didn't know, really knew what the difference was. But now you need to know where the other failure rate comes in. Having the right brokerage account is one thing. Now, telling them to give you the right tools is another. It's funny because I know a lot of you have seen me do presentations before, and on Monday, you're going to be going and running immediately to your brokerage firm and asking them, hey, how do I Fausto, or I was at Cybertrain University Cyber Expo with Fausto and Hubert and John Nigerian. We were talking about total view. Do they even have it? And you'll see that a lot of them don't. And if they don't, what I recommend you to do is contact me and I'll tell you where to get it. Now, what happens, what people always, now people start questioning and start saying, hey, Fausto, I heard about these orders, but people tell me they're really not real. Any of you ever hear of that? There's people hiding orders and can't believe it. Have you heard that? All the time, right? I hear people say it all the time. You can't trust this, Fausto. This is BS. And you know the first thing I tell them? If you don't believe what you see, then what the hell are you trading for? why would you like to trade in a big lot? Why would you go into business to trade something that you think there are a bunch of lots? Right? Guess what? They're not lying. Those are real orders. Okay? For example, look at this example right here. You see that resistance level right there? The stock right now is trading right at the same price. Now, could you guys tell me, by looking at that resistance level, we're trading at that same resistance, what should the stock do right now? Should it go up or down? What should it do? If anyone here knows how to read charts, can you give me a chat? Okay, some of you are staying up, but a lot of you are staying down. Once again, you all have probably taken or have some type of education on a chart, and most people say, well, you look at previous history, and you see resistance, which you can call a pivot point, whatever you want to call it, and a retracement, a double top, whatever you want to call it, teacup, you know, a peak, a valley, you know what I'm talking about. Don't stocks break resistance levels? Doesn't that happen? And you sit there and scratch your head like, how did that happen? How did that stock break a resistance level? Every indicator in the world and everything I was taught said it was going to go down. Why did it break it? I'll tell you why it broke it. Because if you look over here on the bid, you have a 75,000 share buyer out there bidding for stock. Now, that's right, Sarah. There are more buyers out there. So now when you look at it, here you're seeing a big order. BC says, how about just looking at the time and sale since orders can be withdrawn? Well, because first you have to see the order out there, and the only way you know if they're getting executed is through the time and sale. But that's after the effect. This is before. You need to see the orders and see if they get executed. So, for example, you got a big order out there. How many of you here are trading in the market and seeing these big orders? I mean, how valuable is this to you? How valuable does it to see the full orders out there? I mean, my God, I'm running out of text right here. Everyone's just saying, very, priceless. You know, worth a million. These are things all of you guys just chat right now. And you know what? That's what my mentor taught me. He says, Fausto, how in the world do you want to be a successful trader without seeing the orders? Because this data is available to all of you. See, now, when I first started, it wasn't available to the general public. So I had to get licensed. You had to be licensed to trade and everything. But now, with today's technology, the exchanges, the New York Stock Exchange, the CBOE, the New York, they're making it where all of you can have access to the same technology like the market makers. That's why when you look on the floor of the exchange, there's no one there anymore. Because you guys are starting to come in and says, you know what, they've just gave out driver's license out to all of you, and now you could do it yourself. Now, a couple of questions coming across here. Bart has a question, but what's the difference between level 2 and level 3? Well, level 2 only gives you the best bid and best offer of an exchange or a market maker. Level 3 shows you all the orders and all, so it's about 20 times more data. You're seeing every price of every market maker and every ECN at every order he has out there. Where level 2, you only see their best bid and best offer, if that makes sense. A couple of questions are coming across here. And once again, I'm because John was running a little behind, and we have a very tight schedule, I'm going to try to answer some questions when I get to the end. So once again, we still have about 15 slides I got to get through. And then hopefully some of your questions will be answered by some of these slides, and if I have time at the end of the presentation, I'm going to try to answer them, okay? So anyway, moving forward, ECNs, electronic communication network. Basically, these ECNs are what allow you to become a market maker. Now, this is what we teach you here at Cyber Trading University. We show you how to drive the car, how to actually place bids and offers, seeing these orders out there, and understanding why they make supports and resistance levels, and seeing if they're getting executed by time and sales, and knowing who they are, who is the dominating market maker. Is it Goldman? Is it Shearson? Is it Citibank? Is it Knight Securities? These things are what you need to learn. Now, I always get a lot of people ask me, well, what about the high frequency trade? And what about the dark pools? So listen, high frequency trades have been around forever. Okay, it's also known as program trading. Okay, they control 70% of the market. What's wrong of seeing 70% of the volatility? Now, it's extremely scary for some of you here that don't see it. But if I was able to teach you and give you the tools to see 70% of the volume, I mean, how much better of an understanding of what your stock is really doing? I'll give you a great example. Thursday, we did an event. We did an event. I did a live trading demonstration in the market, and we had a great day because what happened was Facebook came out with earnings. Everyone here, everybody saw what happened with Facebook? Okay. If anyone's interested in watching this video, I highly recommend you email me, and I'll get you the recording for it. Okay. Now, Facebook, one thing that would happen with Facebook, I think I have this slide here. Let me just bring it up. Here we go, right here. Here's Facebook. Facebook, you could see, came out with earnings, and oops, looks like I missed the time right here. But what happened was Facebook went from, like, let's say this was 50, it ran to 57 in a matter of 5-10 minutes. I'll put my email address. I'm going to have it posted up there later, guys. But if you need it right now, ctu.com. There you go. All right. And then the stock tanked and went all the way down to here. This is pre-market. In the video, I show you how we shorted the stock. And thank God we covered, because the thing went right back up. You know, and I think it had a swing of literally like almost like $10, you know. So I was doing a demonstration, and I didn't make that much. I think I made like $800 in about, I don't know, 10 minutes. $800 is still a lot of money for some of us. I don't know too many people that make $800. Even though the thing had a 10-point swing, you know, 1,000 shares, 80 cents is a lot. And once again, you can watch it live. One thing I love to do with my students, I love to train and teach you live. But the point I'm getting with Facebook is this. Did you guys see the pre-market trading? Did you see all the ECN orders out there of market makers selling the stock on the ECNs? Did you see these big orders out there, how they were pushing it up, down? How many of you here, how many people do you think went out there and sold the stock and put orders with their online broker and didn't get executed until after the market opened up? And then finding out that you got executed at one price, and then and you couldn't even cancel it. I mean, is that what you want? Is this is what you need? What do you need them for? Why would you want a brokerage firm trading and looking out for his best interest when you could do it on your own? And the thing is, you could see these orders. Here's an example. Going back to charts, you see all these big block orders. big buyers, big sellers. Well, how do you know that that's a real support resistance? You need to see the orders. Now, understand something, ladies and gentlemen. This is like trading 101, okay? And this is what made me realize that I want to do trading as a career. I didn't know it was this simple. And if you notice, I didn't say easy, okay? This simple to trade. A lot of you guys don't realize that you're making trading so complicated by learning so many different things that a lot of you just don't know how to play the game. You don't just know how to look what you need to look at. And the windows that I'm pointing out are the most important windows of a whole execution system. Now, you have to remember, everyone has a style, okay? And what I mean by style, a lot of you are out there saying, oh, I like to trade it this way. I like to trade, I like to bottom fish. I like to watch this type. I like to watch this industry. That's great. But do you know how to play the game? Because football is played with 11 people on defense, 11 people on offense. Okay? Now, maybe you trade the West Coast offense, whatever, of ground and pound. You know, and I'm kind of using sports a little bit, or getting to a car. You know, some of you like to drive fast. You know, so maybe you want a sports car. Some of you like luxury. But what I'm telling you is this. That's great. But do you know how to put the keys in the ignition? Do you know the difference between drive, the D and the R on the shifter? And guess what? A lot of you don't. You like that car, you like to trade this sport, but you don't know how to drive it. And the number one window, which all of you guys need to understand, is how to play the game. It's a game, Marquis, that's right, it's a game within a game. But first you have to learn to play the first part, and then you know how to play, then you learn the second part. A lot of you are going out there and learning the second and third part of the strategies, and that's what you have to do. Because the way I look at all of you here is that, and I know some of you here have children. I know some of them are probably very well grown up. I look at you as my children, okay, and I'm your parent. And you all want to drive that car. I'm not going to give you the keys until I show you how to drive. The problem is with today's markets, there's no law that has to tell you, oh, you want to trade the market? Well, you got to be licensed. You know, because if you did, then you realize what you're learning here is that how much that you don't know. So let's talk about some stocks and what we traded, because we got about less than 20 minutes. Actually, I got about 15 minutes to go, and because we're going to have a five-minute break until we have our next speaker, which is going to be Hubert coming on next. All right. So PSDV. You guys ever hear of this stock before, PSDD? Ever heard of it? No one heard of this stock? Nobody. Oh, we got a couple of yeses. Gerard did. Joe did. Mike did. A lot of them. Okay, well, did you ever hear of stocks up 29%? Now we're getting a lot of yeses. Would it be nice to trade a stock up 29%? Well, one thing that I teach you, and this is one of the mistakes that I was making that my mentor taught me. He said, Fausto, when you trade the market, this is not about trading a stock because you like the company. You're doing this as a job. It's different. It's a different mentality. Okay? You're not, you know, I just did an on-site presentation and I had a real estate broker investor in my class. And he goes, it was the best metaphor understanding of him to understand it. And the thing is, the way I explain it is, you're not buying the house because you want to live in it. You're buying the house because you want to make money with it. Now, granted, you want to live in a great neighborhood, but if you could risk 10 times less money and make the same amount of money, why wouldn't you do that? And this is my point. There are a lot of great companies out there, and there's a lot of them you never heard of. But at the end of the day, we're all here for the same reason, and that is to make money. That is it. And when you're dealing with more brand name stocks, more familiar name stocks, guess what? You're dealing with the best traders on Wall Street. Now, I don't know about you, but I can't beat the best traders. And if I can't beat them, guess what? You can't either. But there are over 10,000 stocks out there. And the way what we teach you at Cyber Trading University, how to strategically how to find them. And believe me, it's not hard at all. You can watch CNBC. You can watch, you know, go through, look at your newsletter, read the paper. But I'll show you how to find them. But let me tell you about one of the biggest mistakes that people do by finding them. They use all these crazy indicators. And the thing you have to learn is that. What is PSDV again? I have no clue. All I know is that it was up 29%. The stock right here on the last half hour of the close, you could see a stock go from $4.80 to $5.30. I mean, you do the math. What is that, 50 cents? You know what 50 cents is on 1,000 shares, and this is only a $5,000 investment? It's a pretty substantial winner, if you ask me. So, you know, I mean, they're brand name stocks like Facebook and Google, but you're dealing with the best traders on Wall Street. Is that what you want to do? I mean, the thing is, you want to look for volatility, but you need to know how to look for volatility smarter. Now, looking for stocks, this is how we do it. Okay, this is what we teach you at Cyber Trading University. First of all, I run a professional trading room. And I know we have some of my traders in here, and they'll be happy to share their knowledge with you. But the way I was trained and the way I will train you is we scan the market going through the percentage gainers list. That's what we do. New York, NYNY, MSTR, YY, you could see all these stocks right here. I mean, you look here in the most active Facebook, Dell, Micron Technology, the QQQ, Sirius Radio. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. But at the end of the day, some of these stocks don't move and don't have the volatility. There are other stocks in this world that do trade. And these are the things that we look at. And trading is a part-time job. This is why we teach. This is why us educators, guys like John and Hubert and Durant and Robert and all these speakers, because people always ask me, if you're such a great trader, why do you teach? I'll tell you why I teach. Because I only work sometimes 15 minutes in the day. What am I supposed to do for the rest of the day? I started when I was 22 years old. I was semi-retired at 24. I was only trading an hour a day. What's a 24-year-old supposed to do after that? People saw me trading. I was making money. People saw it. I was able to show it. And a lot of you here saw that. You know, and I'll show you some of the videos. You'd be happy, email me. I'll show them to you. One thing I do whenever I teach, people always ask me, they say, Fausto, show me your stock picks today, what you did yesterday. I'm going to show you them. I'll show you what I traded on Friday. But one thing I do is I show it live in the market. I trade with my students. I trade with you. I show you how to get in and out of it. That's why I run a professional trading room. I'll give you an example. Let's see what happened on Friday, okay? Does anyone here have like a Twitter account or text messaging? One thing that we do is here at Cyber Trading University, if you are part of our professional trading room, we run a live room all day long, and I'm in there trading with my students. Now, I'm very active. Obviously, I do a live broadcast, audio, video, everything in the pre-market, 30 minutes before the market opens up, and an hour and a half before it closes. And we post all the stocks that we're looking at. For example, any of these stocks look familiar to you guys? Any of these stocks, FSLR, any of these look familiar? If you look right here, look at the time, okay? I want you to focus on these times right here, okay? So what I'm going to do is I want to go to my execution system, and I want to show you all what happened. All right, can everyone see my execution system okay? Just give me a chat back if you can. I just have to tell you guys, it's amazing. I literally got like 20, 30 text messages from all of you here that are trying to get into my Twitter account. All right, but first I'll show you how you get, become a member. All right. First of all, FSLR was my big winner. Now, getting back to the slideshow, you could see I called it at 9 a.m. I do my meetings at 9 a.m. Look what happened. This is an intraday chart. All right. Look what this stock did at 9:30. The stock ran from $54. In less than an hour and a half, it went from $54 all the way up to $58. All right, that was one of the winners. Where am I? Yeah, right here. Here's another one, OSIR. You guys ever heard of this one? Right here in the morning, $13 all the way to $17 in less than an hour. All right, that was one of my picks. Everything on Friday is right here, ladies and gentlemen. Here's another one, SMLS. Show you the losers. Well, like I said, Paul, I'll be happy to show you losers because not every one of these stocks was a mover at the open. All right? What I'm showing you right now is stocks that were moving in the market. You see, everybody here is trying to find stocks that are moving. You see, you have a loser and me having a winner. That's not the concern. The concern is all of you here are probably still looking at stocks like Apple. You know, and look at Apple. Who's going to go risk $500,000? And I know you could trade the options, but look at the difference. Everyone wakes up in the morning and keeps looking at the same damn stock, Apple, Cisco, Microsoft. But what about stocks like FSLR? How about stocks like, you know, NATI? I mean, you see these stocks up huge. What happened on Friday? But Canadian Solar. I don't know if you guys know this, but have you noticed an unusual amount of activity in solar stocks? Have you guys noticed that? This is something we've been trading all month at the solar stocks. And you notice you probably haven't heard them talking about it. SETY was one of our big winners. I mean, as a swing trade, stock was $35 in less than a month. Went to 60, and it was a great day trade, and it was a great swing trade. So, you know, these are the things that we do here at CyberTrade University. And you can see all of them right here. They're all been posted, and we you know, what we do here at CyberTrade University is we run a meeting at 9 o'clock. We're usually done within 15 to 20 minutes. We're all in the trading room, and then we tweet it. And we text message it. So if you don't have Twitter, you can also get text messaging. Matthew said he traded SolarCity and made a killing on it. Once again, finding the stocks is not the problem, okay? That's the easy part. Finding and learning, you know, the big block orders, that's not hard. You know what the hard part is? The psychology, the discipline. Realizing that trading is not investing, it's a job. And your job is here to make money. And making money comes down to one thing. How much money do you want to make? And know what your dailies are, weekly. Think about this for a second. I showed you stocks up $1. But when you really think about it, do you think it's hard to find 20 cents movement? That's it, 20 cents. 20 lousy stinking cents on 1,000 shares is $200 a day, It's a $50,000 year salary. You can't tell me that if I was able to tell you guys, if I was going to offer you, you make $100,000 a year a job, and I say, hey, listen, I have a job for you, a second job, that if you work an hour a day, I can show you how to make $50,000 a year. That's a 50% raise. You think no one's going to want to take that? Of course you would. Of course you would. And that's only 20 cents. Trading is a part-time job, ladies and gentlemen. It's not a full-time job. Now, everyone here wants to know a little bit about dark pools. Listen, my email address, and I answer back all my emails. If anybody wants a copy of the slideshow, the dark pools article, that's my personal email address. I put in the chat. Everyone, you feel free to email me, and I'll send it off to you. Now, I'm running out of time right now because I have the other presenters coming up. I got Hubert coming up next. But for everyone, if you don't know this, Cyber Trading University was ranked number one school 6 years in a row. We run a lot of great cyber expos, which you've noticed. We have great speakers, guys that we've been recognized. Even, you could see John Nigerian, Tom Sosnoff from Thinkorswim. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. And the reason why we're ranked number one school is because the people that are associated with Cyber Trading University are real traders. That's what we are. We're professional traders, and we're here to educate you guys to make you realize how to trade the right way other than doing it on your own. Now, if anybody here would like to be part of my professional trading room, we are running a promotion, a 30-day trial for $19. That's it, $19. You hire me. I'm asking you to hire me for $1 a day. It's 20 trading days in a month. Hire me for $1 a day, and I will promise you, and I will show you professionalism and of trading, how to find them, and how to look at markets of ways that you would never imagine. $1, that's all I ask, $1 a day. Now, if anybody here wants to register for that 30-day trial for $19, just click on that link, or you can go right to our homepage or our website and register for it. All right? Now, this promotion is going to end on Monday because we know a lot of people are going to be watching this recording. They couldn't be here all day. But, if you're interested, the sale does end on Monday. It's the first time we ran it for $19 for a whole month. So, once again, it's a great opportunity for you to watch me personally trade live in the market, okay? And if you'd like to continue your membership after that, it's $200 a month, but you don't have to continue it. You can cancel it, the next day if it's not for you. Now, everything that we put in the live trading room, you could actually watch it. If you can't be there live in a computer, you could watch the videos, the live trading room on your smartphone, and we will also text and tweet it for you if you choose to. All right. A couple of questions coming across here. Does the room talk about options? Yes, and we also talk about Forex. So everything that you guys are talking about, all the traders that are in there are doing exactly what you're doing. All right. Now, I would love to do it for free, but once again, if we did it, we will have 10,000 people in there, and it'll be very, very hard to track. And it's not a social club; it's a trading room. So it's a great way for you guys to get started. All right. A couple of questions here. Now, once again, John was running a little late, and I don't want to take too much time from the speakers, but because I know they're running on a tight schedule, and we're actually very appreciative that they all came on a Saturday to be here. But you know what? They want to be here. They want to give you their knowledge and everything. And that's why we do these cyber expos. So listen, I'm going to be here all day introducing the speakers and talking a little bit about them. And in the middle of the breaks, be able to answer some questions. I'm just going to go through them really quick. Once again, if anybody would like to register for that trial, you can click on that link, or right next to my name, up on the panelists, you see a little button, a personal URL. just click on that link and it'll bring up the browser and it'll bring you right to the webpage. Once again, let me just go through this really quick and answer some questions. A couple of questions. Is there somebody to advise if you personally get stuck into a trade, Gerard? Yes. Remember, we're working together like a team. So if we're not a brokerage firm. We're a trading room. We're a school. So this is what, you know, these are things that we do when we work with our traders. No problem, Renee. Thanks for coming. All right, everyone. Listen, I apologize that I was cut short due to what happened, John running a little late. So I don't want to take away too much time from him. But listen, if you guys have any questions, a lot of questions coming across here. Listen, this is my personal email address. Please email me your questions that you might have that you're chatting right now, and I'll be happy to answer any of your questions. In the meantime, if anybody would like to join the Professional Trading Room, it's a webinar. It's live running all day for $19. Feel free to start registering now. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a couple of minutes break, and I'm going to bring Hubert Centers in. He's going to pick up at 12 o'clock. In the meantime, just give you some time, guys, to register for the promo and email me your questions right now that you might have. All right, guys? So once again, thank you very much, and I will be right back in a few more minutes.